Hello and welcome. Today we are going to start a new project, which is a table tennis touch game. So this is a table tennis touch game. We are going to build this for a mobile, and we are going because we are going to display it on a mobile screen. We are going to build it up to 4,000 triangles, which means that we are not going to exceed 700 k's of vertices. So these are some samples of the game which we are going to make, and this is the high quality which we are going to. So here is some samples of the mobile game. All the rooms or all the spaces are the same. Let's see. These are some reference. All the displays. Let's wait. So all the spaces are the same idea. Here is a tennis table, and this is a robot. And here in the background there is a lobby. So the goal of this project, we are going to see how to make this game in Blender and to export it into Unity. We are going to see the process of how to enable textures and how to export. We can also to make textures in cycles. And as you can see, the all scenes are the same idea. And what I'm going to rebuild is this base. We have here this tennis table, and we have here the table, and in the background we have some windows and column. We can see some other curtains here. We are going to make all this, as I have said, to be low poly, and we can see some lamps here, and some decorations in the wall. And let's get started by starting a new scene. Before I start with Blender, I can see how I organize my folder. Here is the reference, which has some reference from the internet, and another folder, which is the textures we will put here in Bump Web. I will put here in the textures folder the Bump Web and the Circularity Web. And in the UV folder here, which I will export UVs after we unwrap every model. And finally, if I go to render, I will put the renders in this folder. So I have started a new scene before I start. So the room has the dimensions of 11 meters, which is the width, and 20 meters, which is the length of this room. As I have said, I will try to rebuild this scene, and I will close the others because it's very simple. And later, if I can recopy some other stuff from the other ideas. So let's get started by making the room. I will hit Shift C, and first I will enable the screencast keys. And as you can see, so I will start by adding a new cube, and every time I will enable the length to be in meters. So in the dimensions, the width has some, in the x-axis I will say we have 11 meters, and in the y-axis we have 20 meters. Let's see in the top view. So this is the dimensions. Anyway, I will invert the dimensions. So in X we have 20 meters, and in Y axis we have 11 meters. And also the height of this room will be, let's say, 22.9. And let's see, in the Z axis I will move G and Z. We have 1.45 to make it in the grid floor. And as you can see, we have now the room, we can make it tall to be, let's say 3.5 meters, which is the height. And as you can see, the room now isn't in the grid. We will G on Z and hit Control. G on Z, and it will be, let's say it will be here. So the next step is to separate the floor. So I will go to, so in the viewport sheeting, we have this solid, we have the wireframe, and we have some also the texture and the material viewport sheet. And I will separate, let's go to front view and separate. What I'm going to make is Control 7 to go to the bottom view and separate this floor. So we have now this floor separate. Let's see. I mean, to select this floor, we have this floor separated from this room. And to be organized from the first, I will name every object like this. We have this, let's say it will be the room, and the other thing, it will be the floor. And each material has its own textures, and each material and each object has its own folder. Let's get started by making the stairs in this in the back. So we have the stairs, let's see, it will has the height of 50 centimeters, and it's extended to be something like, let's say it has 5 meters. So in a new layer, I will add a cube, and this cube, let's start by a plane, and this plane will have a width of 1 meter and extended from here to around 4 meter or 5 meter. And after that, we have, let's try to make the stairs. So every step, let's say it will be 5 centimeters. So after that, we will extrude on x 0.15. Each time extrude in x 0.15, and again extrude on x 0.15, we have 4 steps. And after that, select all and extrude on z 0.15, and again the next step is to select all except this one and extrude on z 0.15 again, deselect and extrude g on z 0.15 and deselect, and the final step, g on z 0.15, extrude on z 0.15. So we have now made, I think the problem is to z 0.15. So we have now remade some steps. We have now these steps 1.4 up to 4, and it's the same dimensions as we have in this one. So let's go to layer 1 and put the stairs in the right dimensions, and we can give the orient to geometry and g on y, and it will be in this area. So I think the stairs, it will be extended to around 2 meters, g on 2 meters, like this. Let's see how it looks. So the next step is to make this trash can or something like that. So I will make simple trash can, and after we applying simple materials to it, it can be the same like it's here. And let's try to make in a new layer, or layer 2, Shift C, and we will add some a cube. So this cube is has dimensions of 2 meters. So I'm going to make a dimensions of 0.4 in x and 0.4, and let's see z axis will be 1 meter, and let's see if we have this trash can, and it seems that we have in z axis point let's say 0.6 meters, which is the same dimension, and we will move in z axis around 0.3 to stick in the grid floor. And we have here to enable, I will go to editing and align to view to make the around to make it better to go in this window. So we have now this trash can, and after that we can make it similar to this one. So we have two different ideas. We have this circular one. So let's start by making this square or rectangle one. So we will scale shift Z around this shape, and again it will be like this. And now it's the time to make two loop cuts here, and we can delete all these faces and again go here and extrude on z axis. It will be like this, and in the right view we can scale on y axis to be like this. So we have made the first one. Let's move it to layer 3 and shift C. Let's make this circular one. Again, it has the same dimensions, so we will start by a circle. This circle will have 8 vertex, and in the radius will be 0.2. Let's start by 0.25. And this circle in the front and aligned to the front view. So I will rotate in x axis and again select this and z axis to be something like here. And if you look here, you can see that the top of this trash can is the same height as this stairs. So we can identify that the height of this trash can is 60 meters. Because we have, let's go here, because we have each step is 0.15 meters, which is 15 centimeters. So we will start by extruding it to the same height and scale shift Z, and again we will scale shift Z to be like this. We can isolate this trash can and extrude scale shift Z and fill this area. So we have now made this trash can, and make sure that in the bottom view we have this filled with an polygon, which is a quad, 4 faces at each edge, and this may be suitable if you go to make a high poly model, or you can apply subdivision service. So we have made this low poly trash can, and again we have finished it. So again we have, if you have look at the side, we have this door and we have windows and we have these decorations and the lamps. We have a lot of things in the background, but if you want to add the same details as you can see here, you will require a lot of time, a lot of vertex, a lot of space, a lot of RAM, and this isn't suitable for a mobile game. And again we are going to make an globally models which is can run correctly in the mobile. So let's start by making this table. So I will move this to layer 3 and re-isolate. So we have here is this one, and I find it suitable to, let's move them. So we have these two ones, and I will move it temporarily to layer 5. And again, in layer number 3, Shift C to make cursor at the center. And if you have take a look at this table, you can see that the height is around 80 meters, and this sign may be around 25 centimeters. So I will start as all time in the front view. I will start by this plane, and this plane in I will rotate on Z 90 degrees and go to the right view, and in let's move in Z axis 1 meter, and I will in the X axis I will say I have 0.5 meters, and in the Y axis let's say in the Y axis we have centimeters, so 0.5 and 0.8. So in the Z axis here we have 0.8 and G on Z like this. Make sure that if you want to let's see, we have this here, and if you want to snap this when you're moving, control to snap it to the grid. And if you have zoom to let's say this scale, and if you hit control you will snap to the millimeters, and it's I have seen that it's this is helpful let's say feature, because if you can let's say snap to the grid or millimeters, and if you go here you can snap to centimeters, and if you go to this view you can snap to meters, and it's helpful. So let's again here and move to the axis, and again selection to cursor. So we have made this plane, and again we will make some thickness. So this thickness, let's say it will be 3 centimeters. This thickness is around 3 centimeters. So we will go to the top view and extrude on X axis to be around 3 centimeters. And again, we will make loop cut here in the middle. And so the loop cut will be in not in this object. So I will start by selecting the top view and extrude again 0.3 centimeters, and select this one and extrude on X, let's say it will be around minus 0.045, G around 45 centimeters. So we have this one, and let's make this next which is support for the table, and this support is around 4 centimeters and the same height. So we will start by select this edge. We will select this edge, and we can say Shift D on Z and separate by selection, this edge we will move. So I will move this after enable the snap element on Z axis to be here. And again, extrude on Z to be so I'm going to move in Z axis to be the same height like this. And again, I will make loop cut to be around this one, and again some loop cut here. Make sure that shift tab to enable snap and to disable this snap. And the most one I am using is vertex snap. So let's make loop cut here and bevel to be this. So we have finished to some geometry like this. Don't forget to add loop cut to the top view. And again, we will delete. We have made this one and delete these two faces. Let's isolate, and in the top view, we will extrude on Y axis around 2 centimeters and 5 millimeters. Again, move the origin to the geometry. Let's see, we have this one, and with the table, it's the same one. I'm not sure it has something in the other side or not, but we can make it by select this one, and let's rename it to be table, and this is to be support. Again, we will add and mirror modifier. This mirror modifier will be around mirror object to be table and mirror. So as you can see, the table isn't correctly. It must be here in the other side because we haven't applied rotation and scale to each of these ones. So as you can see, it's here in the other side. Again, we have the freedom to enable this mirror modifier or to so let's apply the mirror modifier. So we have these two ones. Anyway, we will start making this. Let's say it will be sine or has the score of each player, and it's very simple. Let's make here go in the top view and make the cursor here and add in a plane. This plane will be 20 centimeter by 20 centimeter and move around here. You can enable the snap element to be here, and again we will make this to this distance, and after that we will extrude some space around this, and again extrude on Z around minus 0.2 centimeters, and now we have made this sign. So we have finished around half of this space. And the next step is to make this table. And as I have looked at dimensions of this table, we have the width, total width of 1.5.25, and we have, let's, so I have opened this image to draw some lines. So we have here the total lines around 20 meters, and we have this space around, so we have this space around 11 meters, and I can say that we have this table. I have looked to the dimensions. We have width this width is around 1.525, which is the width. And the length of this table is 2.74 meters. And the height is around 76 centimeters. And the net, so we will start by these dimensions, 2.74 and 1.525, and the height will be 76 centimeters. And also we will make the most important item in this tennis game, which is the racket and the ball. And we will also make this net. And so I have started a new layer, which is layer number 4, and shift C to make the cursor at the center. And I will add another plane. This plane has dimensions of, as I have said, 1.525 in the x-axis and in the y-axis we have 2.74, and we have here the basic dimensions. Now this we will move on Z. We have said we have some height and again some thickness. This thickness extrude on Z, let's say 5 centimeter. Around 8 centimeters to be the same as the source here. And again we have some supports as usual. So I will make basic supports. Let's first rename this to be tennis table. And again we will make some support. So shift C and we will add let's say we have a circle. So this circle will be 8 vertex and rotate on X 90 degrees. Scale shift Z 0.2 and move on X axis to be the same location as here. And again extrude on Z to be the same dimensions, the same height as the table, and we can isolate at this stage. So if you have looked here, we have we can I think we can make so let's stick with this circle. And again select these ones and delete, and also you can delete this edge, and also select this one, extrude on Y, and this one will be here and extrude on X to be G on X axis to be like this. And again we have made this one. So let's start to make the support. The support is simple cube. So in the object mode I will add a cube, and this cube will be 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter. And again we will, let's try to add some Z, let's say 0.3.
And let's enable the dimensions. And here we have this cube. This cube will be the support which you have seen here. As you can see, we have this support, and it will be the same in this one. And I have seen it, if we have increased the XY to be 0.2, it will be better. And rotate in, let's scale on the axis like this and rotate on Y axis. Move also in the Z axis like this. And what I'm looking for is to make the same dimensions in each size. And again, in the edit mode, shift D on Y axis and rotate like this, and also move in Y axis to be around here. Let's see how it looks in the right view, and it must be mirrored. Let's select this one, and it must be mirrored in Y axis or rotated in X axis to be here. Let's see. If we moved it here, and we must move all these ones to be here, and we can. What I am looking for is to make it the same dimensions or exactly dimensions, because I will join these ones like this and mirror them. I will not make because we have all the supports or legs the same dimensions. I will select this one and apply the mirror modifier. Let's see mirror modifier around the tennis table. And again, apply another mirror modifier and select the tennis table, this time in the Y axis. So we from only one support, we have make the other three supports. And once you have UV unwrapped this one, you will be UV unwrapped three in the same time. Let's see how it looks, or we have any errors. So we haven't any errors, and all support is from all angles is very, very nice. And the next step is to make this net. This net is around let's see, in the what I'm looking for, I have the exact dimensions of this net. You can search online for the dimensions of the net. So the dimensions of the net around in the length 1.83 meters, and the height is 1.5 to 5. The height is 0.15 to 5. All right. So we have if we look to make the same geometry, we will consume a lot of vertex. But I'm looking for using the transparent shader. So let's start by making the first one. So we have an plane, and this plane is in the Y axis 0.1525, and in the other is this dimensions. And again, we will move move on z axis to be snapped correctly to this one. As you can see, we have made the dimensions, and shift C, we want to make it middled in this one, so we will shift S cursor to selected and selection to cursor. Again, it has now at the middle, so we will move on Z axis. And we will make at the same time some thickness extrude on the around, let's say, point one, which is 1 centimeter. And again, we have at each edge some, let's say, some support or some edge. And again, don't forget that we have here some edge, which is white edge, as you can see here. And again, we want to make this one, let's say, and this one. So it's very simple. We will start again from a plane, and this plane we will scale and rotate to be like this. So we will scale on y-axis to be the same. Let's disable the snapping and scale on y-axis to be like this. And what I'm looking for in this time is to move them to be here and extrude on z-axis like this. And select this one and move to be here. And we have this final thing, which is the support. So we can make it by using a cube. So the final thing which I am looking to make is this object, which is here. It can be a screw or something like this. So in this one, we can make a circle which has 6 vertex in the options, and we have the radius to be 1 centimeter and rotate and extrude some thickness to be here. We can scale it to be like this. As you can see, the normals is flipped, so we will recalculate the normals. And again, we can extrude on the axis to be like this. So now I can say that we have finished one part. The next step, so as you can see, we have made one side. The other side, it will be mirrored using the mirror modifier, and choose the tennis table, and it will be in the other side. Each one will be mirrored around tennis table in the x-axis, mirrored around tennis table in the x-axis. So now we have successfully finished this tennis table, and let's move to the next part. So we have this racket which I will make finally, and let's start to make the windows and the lamps in the background, and we can also see that we have some curtains. So as you can see, we have three windows. Let's say each window have an distance 1.5 and 1.5 from each side, and the height is around 1 meters. So let's get started. In the layer number one, we have two edges like this, and again we have the height to be like this. We have three windows, if we can say we have three windows, and the control B to add bevel. And what I'm looking for is to make it symmetrical by choosing every one and like this. So I see that the height isn't the same height as in the reference. So we have now see that we have three windows. These windows, let's see, it's the same. I can see that the windows isn't the same. Where is the problem in this one? So in the first of this video, I have said that this is the width. So we can flip it to be, let's hide this floor. We have the floor. So we have this room, and we will move the floor to another layer. Let's Alt H. So in the beginning of this video, I have said that this is the width. But if we flipped it to be like this, it will be better, because in the reference I have find that this width is 11 meters, and this is the width and this is the height. I mean, this is the length which is 20 meters, and this distance is 11 meters. So let's get started by making two loops here, and these loops will be like this, and we have two distance. Every distance here we have around some windows here, and again we will add a height here. And as you can see, we can add some, if we select all these faces and scale on X. What I'm looking for is to make, let's scale first. What I'm looking for is to make this distance, which is here, is around 1.5, and as you can see, it's around 1.4 and is close to which is in the reference. So in the back view, if we look here, in the back view, I will select this face, and so I will delete these faces and select each edge of, let's select one by one. Because we have selected a lot of objects, we can enable individual ordinates. let's talk about individual ordinals if we moved here and to scale each one at its individual ordinals, which is here, and we can scale shift y, and this feature is really, really helpful. As you can see, it can be animated if you can use it for three dimension, and as you can see, this feature is very, very helpful. And let's go to make a thickness of around 20 centimeters. And the next step is to make these curtains and make these decorations. And this decoration is very, very simple. We will go, what I'm looking for is to select these edges and these edges, enable bounding box and scale to be something like this. And in this face, I will say the cursor to be selected and add in the object mode, I will add a cube, so we can add a plane. As you can see, when you add a plane in the user or in the perspective mode, it's not aligned perfectly. And as you can see, here rotation of 30 and this rotation. So we will make the rotations to be zero at all axes. And now this plane is flat. And as you can see, we can rotate and scale 0.5. Now we have, let's see, we have 1 meter by 1 meter. We can apply the scale and let's scale on x axis. If you are confused, we are now making this yellow decorations at around the curtains.